I wanted to finish that up with a statement that Mayor Michael Blooming Idiot Bird.
Yeah, Blooming made. Idiot Bird.
Yeah. And this guy, oh man, let me just read the statement. All right, here's what he says. After the resistance happens, people shred the documents, the registration forms in the street. He comes out and says, I pledge to spend $50 million combating pro-gun groups, including the NRA.
I saw that.
Now, two bizarre statements that he makes in saying that
only
he's going to do this.
Only two?
Well, yeah, only two that we can repeat on air.
He's like Joe Biden. Every time he opens his mouth, something bizarre comes out.
That's a moron. But anyway, he says, we've got to make them afraid of us. Them being you and I.
Afraid.
Yes, Mr. Bloomberg, I'm shaking in my boots. Actually, I think, sir, after the resistance in the state of New York, it is you who should be afraid.
Right.
But that's what he says. We've got to make them afraid of us. Then he goes on to say, and this is where it gets crazy. He says, I have earned my place in heaven.
Oh, my gosh.
I guess because he's saying that he's fighting the battle for gun control.
Right.
That's earned him a place in heaven.
Listen.
So it's not my job to be his judge.
That's right.
But, Mr. Bloomberg,
again,
judging by your fruits and your actions, sir, I would not count on earning your place in heaven.
Well, first of all, the gospel message is clear. No one can earn their place in heaven.
Yeah.
All right, salvation is given by God's grace through faith alone. And the Bible says even that's God's gift to us.
Not even 50 million?
And not even 50 million can get you a place in heaven. But what he's talking about, see, here's this perverted way of thinking. Well, first of all, let me just say, if he literally could wave a wand and take the guns out of the hands of the thugs, the rapists, the robbers, the murderers, the criminals, and they would just disappear tomorrow and only law-abiding, decent people would have guns, I would say, you know what? God might make an exception and let that man come up. You know what I'm saying? If he could do that. And,
right.
But what he, in his perverted mind, he's thinking anybody that owns a gun is a thug.
Well, because in his mind, see, you and I are the problem.
Right.
Because they can't rule us as long as we can defend ourselves. That's why the Second Amendment is in the Constitution. Not only for a well-maintained militia, but what's the second part of that?
That's right.
To defend against tyrannical government, even if it's our own government.
Right.
And God, let's just pray that it never comes to that.
Right.
But these people are getting crazier and crazier by the day.
Right.
I mean, look, just yesterday, Harry Reid comes out and says that anybody, the supporters of Clive and Bundy, and we'll get into who he is and that story a little more, but the supporters of Clive and Bundy are nothing more than, quote, domestic terrorists.
Yeah.
Now, what's important about that? Harry Reid's an idiot. I don't care what he says, but what's important about that is this. When the NDAA was passed, and we sat right here and talked about
what that could mean
for you and I, everyday American citizens,
right.
And we've got Obama and Holder up there saying, oh no, we can't detain citizens, only people that are classified as terrorists. And what did we say? When does the definition of terrorist change? Well, we've been screaming and then been proven right that it's been in Army manuals for several years now that conservatives, Christians, people who believe in end time prophecy, returning veterans, gun owners are now classified as domestic terrorists.
As potential domestic
terror threats.
That's right.
All right, we've been screaming, and we've been proven right. Fox News finally had to admit that.
Right.
Finally had to admit that that was true. Now, Harry Reid says anybody that stands against a criminal, armed federal agency is a domestic terrorist.
Right.
No, Mr. Reid, we're doing what the Constitution told us.
And what our founding fathers did.
And what our founding fathers did when a tyrannical government was coming here and doing what to them?
Right.
Taxing them with no representation.
Right. And at gunpoint.
At gunpoint, that's right. The power
seizing
to
their
tax
property,
is the power
seizing
to
their
rule.
Property, putting them in prison, a la Bundy.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, and as a matter of fact, the leaders in power now, and remember, don't forget, when Obama went in office the very first time, Nancy Pelosi says, we're ready to rule from day one.
That's right.
And she meant that.
Yeah.
We made fun of her back then, but she meant, we're ready to rule. These socialist, communist, Marxist thugs are ready to rule. They've been ruling. They see themselves as rulers and emperors. And now Blooming Idiot Berg says we've got to make them afraid of us.
Yeah.
Them are you and me. And us is the ruling
the
class.
The ruling, the power.
We've got to make them, that is Americans who own guns, which, by the way, is over 100 million of us,
that's right.
A third of our nation, Yeah. Owns multiplicities of weapons.
It's estimated that over 100 million Americans own firearms, and there are over 400 million individual firearms inside the United States. That's the ones they know about.
And that's what the blooming idiot birds hate.
Yes.
We've got to make them afraid. Let me just tell you, Mr. Bloomberg, we're not afraid of you.
We're not afraid of you, sir.
We're not afraid of you.
And Mr. Reed, we're not afraid of you.
No,